In this video, we will be discussing about the practical use of electric charges by an electrostatic motor. What is an electrostatic motor? An electrostatic motor or capacitor motor is a type of electric motor based on the attraction and repulsion of electric charges. Now, we will see the construction and working of the electrostatic motor. In the first step, we will make the rotor for the structure. A rotor is the spinning part of the motor. To make it, we will cut some pieces of foil and paste them on the cup by spacing them evenly around the cup so that they are approximately 1 cm apart. For the next step, we will make the structure and connections for the circuit. For its construction, we will use a steel rod and fix it in the middle of a non-conducting base. Now, we will fix two copper wires in standing position as shown in the model. These two wires should be at least 1 cm apart from the rotor. For the connections, we will connect one wire to a good earth point or any other body which removes charge from the foil, and other wire to a source of static electric charge such as charged balloon. You can also use Van de Graaff generator for this purpose. Now I will explain the working of the electrostatic motor. As you add static charge to the unconnected end of the system, it is transferred to the piece of foil nearest to it, giving it the same charge as the balloon or any other charged body. Like charge is repelled, so the foil is pushed away from the wire. This turns the rotor. When the rotor turns, it brings the next piece of foil to collect charge, and also move the first piece towards the earth connection to discharge. The top speed of your motor will be controlled by friction on the balance point and by air friction on the cup. This ends the topic, but for your safety, don't connect the free ends of copper wire to any
today, I'll try to explain electric field to you. In this video, we will talk about visualizing the electric field that is created by a point charge and draw a relationship between the physical representation and the mathematical explanation of an electric field. I am using PET simulation here. You can also try it and see yourself. Here are a couple of options. Last one, nanocoulomb charge, -1 nanocoulomb charge and sensors. As we all know, charges are of two types, positive and negative. So first of all, we will try to understand the direction of electric field lines. Now let us first take positively charged point source and place it here like this. We see that positively charged point source emits an electric field that radiates outwards from the source. These lines here are actually field lines, electric field lines that are coming from the point source, and as we move further and further, these lines start to fade away. This means that the strength of the electric field is strongest near the point charge and weakest when taken away. These directions here, these vectors here tell us actually in what direction will this point charge accelerate. Now let me put it back here and take negative charge. We can see that the electric field lines are now pointing towards the source of the charge and are strongest near the source, and as the distance increases, these lines also fade away. Now let us learn the use of sensor here. Let me again put the positively charged particle here and put the sensor far away from it, somewhere here. Because it's so far away, the value of the electric field coming is very, very small. And we can see that by seeing how fade the lines are. Now, let's bring the sensor closer to the particle. We can see there is no effect on the sensor as yet. Now, let me bring it more close. As I am bringing it closer to the particle, the electric field gets stronger, and we can see the red arrow of the sensor particle. This arrow tells us about the direction the particle is going to accelerate. Due to the force being exerted from the point source onto the sensor, and what's causing the force on the sensor are our test particles, is the electric field. The electric field is how charged particles interact with one another when you place one particle, for example, our sensor particle, close to the test particle, and the particle exerts an electric field on each other, and the magnitude of the force is proportional to the electric field that the particle is experiencing. Now let me do the same for the negatively charged particle. Just like the positively charged particle, the negatively charged particle will also make the sensor experience an acceleration, but in the inward direction. As it is clear? Now, let us see how these positive and negative particles will interact with each other. We have an electric field from a positively charged particle combining with the electric field from a negatively charged particle. And now what happens is that the electric field starts from the positively charged particle and ends up terminating on the negatively charged particle. Now, if I keep the sensor near the positively charged particle, it wants to accelerate away from that particle and ultimately pulled in accelerating towards the negatively charged particle. Now, I would suggest to try this yourself using different combinations of charges.
As Riya has explained electric field through visualization, now I am going to enhance your knowledge by demonstrating a fun activity known as electroscope. Material required: a jar, cloth, steel wire, aluminium foil and a PVC pipe. Firstly, we'll make a hole in the cap as already have been done. Now put the jar aside. Take the steel wire and bend one end as shown. Like this. Now take the cap, adjust the wire. After adjusting, bend the second end as shown. It should look like U-shape. Take two strips of aluminium foil and make hole like this. Now put the foil strip like this. Adjust the cap on PVC pipe for some time. After rubbing the pipe for some time, you can see that the pipe is moving and the strips are also moving like that. You can see after rubbing the aluminum foil for a while, the aluminum foil pieces in jar are moving. You can do this activity by yourself.
इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज बेसिकली पहले हमें पता होना चाहिए इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज होता क्या है. इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज किसी भी एक बॉडी का ऐसा कैरेक्टरिस्टिक होता है कि वो किसी दूसरी बॉडी पे फोर्स लगा सके, और वो उस फोर्स का नाम क्या होता है, वो फोर्स होती है इलेक्ट्रिक फोर्स. ठीक है, अब ऐसा नहीं है कि सारे मटेरियल जो होते हैं उनमें चार्ज नहीं होता. चार्ज हर एक मटेरियल में होता है, लेकिन जो न्यूट्रल मटेरियल होता है उनमें जो चार्जेस ऑपोजिट चार्जेस होते हैं वो बैलेंस्ड होते हैं. जैसे कि ये कॉम्ब है, ये अभी एक न्यूट्रल मटेरियल है. ठीक है, तो इसके न्यूट्रल होने के कारण हम देख सकते हैं ये किसी भी पीस को अट्रैक्ट नहीं कर रहा है. जैसे आप देख सकते हैं ये किसी भी कागज के पीस को फोर्स अप्लाई नहीं कर रहा, उस पर कोई भी फोर्स अप्लाई नहीं कर रहा. जैसा कि हम देख रहे हैं, जब मैं इन टुकड़ों के पास लेके जाता हूँ इनको, तो ये मूव करना स्टार्ट कर देते हैं. ठीक है, इससे हमें क्या पता चलता है, इससे हमें पता चलता है कि जो कॉम्ब है इसमें एक चार्ज जनरेट हो गया है, और ये जो चार्ज है इसको कहते हैं हम इलेक्ट्रिक चार्ज.